Family. What's up? What's cracking? Hey, man. I was trying to go live. I don't know how to go live on my computer. I'm just going to be all the way up in it with you. But look at this. Young Thug is free. Free as blood. Young Thug pleads guilty to criminal activity charges in Georgia's longest ever criminal bullshit charge. You feel me? That is crazy. So it said that Young Thug pleaded guilty and was sentenced to time served, and 15 years of probation on Thursday. Today, October 31st, ending his year-long racketeering trial in Atlanta, the longest criminal trial in Georgia's history. Okay, all right. According to these particular stations, the 33-year-old rapper, whose name is Jeffrey Williams, entered into a plea deal with Fulton County District Attorney's Office today on Thursday. Judge Paige Reese Whitaker sentenced Williams to 40 years, but commuted time served and probation. Per CNN and Associated Press, he will be released from custody on Thursday. Is that Thursday today? He leaving today, son? And now to serve 15 years on probation. If he violates the probation, he can serve 20. So that means you're on paper for 15. That is not like a scot-free, I can't do shit. So, but it's stipulations. It's stipulations. That's part of the deal. Williams pleaded guilty on several charges, including three drug charges, two gun charges, and one gang charge. All right? He also pleaded no contest, meaning that he accept the conviction, but did not admit guilt in the crimes. To racketeering, conspiracy, and participating in criminal street gang as a leader. Like he's a gang leader. But that's the homie right there. Yeah, I was afraid of this dude. Goodness. All right, so the Go Crazy rapper first indicted on May 22nd. He just gave the history, along with 27 others, including rapper Garner violating Georgia's racketeering, influence, and corrupt organizations act, which is the RICO Act. The group accused of taking part in the alleged street gang Slime Life, or YSL, named similarly to the chart-topping artist label Young Stoner Life Records. Members are accused of committing several crimes, including murder, armed robbery, drug dealing, and carjacking. So I wonder if he pissed somebody off why he's thinking it happened. Because we know that with his trial, it was an absolute mess. The first judge was stupid as fuck. So the second judge was like, all right, first judge was so damn bad, and we have held this kid in here all this time. We have no evidence. We had Woody on the stand for a while, and he was like, I'm not testifying to nothing. So it's like, eventually we knew that at some point, they had to let this kid go. So they did. I'm not glorifying or saying that, I'm not sure what he did, because he was never convicted with the things they said he did, just for the things that got listed here. Not with murder or things like that. I just need, maybe when he get out, or should I say, as he gets out, just keep his nose clean. As the second indictment was brought, August 22, brought six more felony charges against Williams per the AP. Amongst the serious charges in the case, Williams was accused of being connected with Donovan Thomas, a rival gang member who died January 2015 by drive-by shooting. Prosecutors alleged Williams rented the vehicle that was used in the shooting, so he's trying to get him with conspiracy and accessory. It's just pictures. It's just an article I got from People. Williams has been in custody since 2022. We know that attorneys have filed multiple motions in his mistrial, including a filing last week, which I agree. If you don't have anything on this kid, you should have been let this kid go. Point blank. You're just holding him up. I don't understand it. The jury selection process took more than a year. Why? I don't understand it. If he was convicted, Williams' case was also marked with controversy and drama, including the past judges being recused. And from the case, and the rapper's attorney, Brian Steele, being charged with contempt. Now, his lawyer was gangster, for real. If he was convicted at trial, Williams could have faced a maximum of 120 motherfucking years. And this was a Rolling Stone, but we all know. I mean, if you came up with trial, you already know that. Yeah, that could have easily happened if the prosecutor had ducks in a row, or if they could prove that he did what they say he did. So they handed out RICOs like it's candy. So if you're part or you have any interest in whatever activity you're doing, young boys, do not go to the route that they can also throw a RICO at you, because if they do, it's a wrap. You already know it. All right, what else we got here? So Williams' case is also marked with controversy and drama, including past judgment. Okay, we read that already. If he was confused, 120, okay. Three of Young Thug's co-defendants, Marius Nichols, 29, McQuavius, and Rodellis, cool names, also took the plea to this deal. Okay, so did they get out too? All right, so it looks like that's basically what it is. Okay. I just want to get that to you guys real quick. Hot from the streets. Hot from the motherfucking streets. But homie is out. Just looking through and see what else we got here. Any other news? Takes a plea 3 hours ago. Takes a plea. Blah, 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 blah. It's just who he is. All right, this is Wikipedia type stuff. The CNN, what they said. They write that in Atlanta. Reverend Young Thug sentenced to time served in a long-running trial. And then there he is right there. Okay. Sinister Sam serves part of the sweeping case that originated in dozens of defendants. The rapper, whose name is Jeffrey Woods. This is something we've already read before. So it's just the same stuff. Just saying that. Basically, I mean, he's out. He's free. 15 years of probation. In comparison to what he could have gotten, 120 years locked up. That 15 years probation on paper is a deal. I mean, it really is. You just have to make sure you keep your doors clean and do stay in the stipulations of what the probation requires. Because if he violates that shit, he's done. He's really done. And they don't have to go to trial to do that. They just take you and you out. What is it saying here? Several defendants charged in the case included rapper Young Gunna took plea deals. Or had their cases severed from the trial. Okay, you know, they had been one of the six defendants on trial together. The rapper had been in jail since May 2020. We know that. When the judge asked if he would like to make a comment on Thursday, Williams said he takes full responsibility and apologizes to his family before asking Fulton County Superior Court Judge Paige Reese Whitaker to let him go home. Amen. I'm a smart guy. I'm a good guy. I really have a good heart. Williams told the judge as he stood before her. I found myself in a lot of stuff because I was just nice or too cool. I understand that. I'm kind of the same way myself. I understand that you can't be that way when you reach a certain height because it could end you badly. So that I do understand what he was saying. He probably is a good kid. So. Williams said, I learned from my mistakes. He mentioned that some of the free concerts he hosted and money he's given to single parents. So he just said that, all right, I'm a good guy. I got caught up in a bad situation. I know better now. This was a hard lesson to learn and a hard way to learn it. And going forward, I'm going to make sure that I do the right thing. You know what I'm saying? So, and that's cool. So you got to do a free concerts, dedication to gang violence, against gang violence, and other things like that. So there's a few stipulations they have for him. So what else we got down here? Before he posed the sentence, Whitaker told Williams, the judge told Young Thug, I want you to try to be more of a solution and less of a less of a problem. The case drew fierce criticism over prosecutors' use of rap lyrics, proof of gangs, actions, and existence. Said some racist violations of some freedom of speech and artistic expression, and the latest instance of black art being targeted. So this is just what CNN is saying. It's just saying that the lyrics, the artistic expressions, how they portray themselves artistically, can be used against them. It has been used against it because they did listen to music and listen to lyrics and listen to all kind of stuff. So, all right. What else is said here? William told the judge today he understood how rap music lyrics can be twisted. He's very right. And he said that the impact they have on other people's lives. So you understand the way they can be twisted and the impact they have on other people's lives. All right. I promise you 100%, I'm changing that, William said. All right. Whitaker ordered that Williams remain away from the metropolitan area beginning 2 days following his release from custody. So she wants him away for the first 10 years. He can't go back to Atlanta for the first 10 years of his probation. Williams is allowed to return to Atlanta for weddings, funerals, graduations, but must leave within 48 hours of those events ending, according to Whitaker. So only special events, he comes to Atlanta, only special events. And they're listed here, of course. William must perform 100 community hours of service during his probation years and is not allowed to normally have any contact with members or associates of any criminal gang, street gang, according to the judge. Williams would have to face, if so, Williams would have to face a maximum of 120 years prison sentence if he's convicted on all charges. So just think about it. This is what they were trying to give him. This is what they were trying to give him off the rip. You know what I'm saying? So off with the conspiracies, the RICOs, all that shit that they laid out to him. They had him sitting in court for sitting in trial for 2 years, over 2 years, and they were trying to give his ass 120 years. So kudos to the defense attorneys and everybody that fought and prayed for this kid, because now he been buried a motherfucking lie. Hold on. This case was dragged for months, including the multiple motions for mistrial. They had already asked for a mistrial because they know it should have been done months ago, or almost a year ago, actually. The most recent being last week. So just last week, they asked for a mistrial. The jury selection process alone took over a year. Wow. The three co-defendants in the YSL racketeering trial has accepted the plea deal agreements this week from the Fulton County District Attorney. So they probably got something similar to what Young Thug got. Rodelius Ryan, known as Lil Rod, co-defendant Marquavius Huey, also as Quay, entered pleas on Wednesday, charged to violate the state's RICO Act. As part of their terms, Ryan accepted 3 years. Ooh, look at this. Ryan accepted a 3 year prison, 10 year prison sentence, which was commuted as time served. Okay, so he got off. Other counts in the indictment included armed robbery were dropped as part of the agreement. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not celebrating that anybody got off for doing something that they should not have been doing, because it's all bad. This shit's all bad. Just be very honest with you. But the thing is that when you get to a situation like this and the feds get involved, that's a big-ass wake-up call for you. So hopefully these kids get out and they keep their nose clean. Or they'll be buried alive in jail. Ryan is currently serving a life sentence for a separate murder case. So the other kid is already serving life. That's fudged up. So for him, it didn't matter. So the prison time will run concurrently with what he said. As a part of his plea deal, Huey admitted... Hold on. Where's Ryan? So Ryan, which is Rodelius, known as Lil Rod. So Lil Rod... They got time served, but he was already serving a life sentence. Oh, it's fine, so it's no relief for Lil Rod. He been done. All right, so Quay accepted a plea deal Tuesday for count one of the indictment, conspiracy of violating the RICO Act. He received a negotiated sentence of 20 years, with 7 years to be served in custody and the remaining of the years on probation. In exchange for multiple counts, including murder, were dismissed. Wow. They could have buried him, too. So he received a negotiated sentence of 20 years, with 7 years of his time served. So he'll, 13 years? And with good behavior, he may be out of his swing. None of the three individuals who entered the plea guilty were required to testify against the remaining co-defendants, including the main target of the case, Gunther. And that's the end of CNN's report on it. All right, guys out. You guys can't see the K here. Hello. Anyway, yeah, he's out. But then we can see it. Yeah. Gunther is out. Hey guys, like I say, I wanted to bring you guys that real quick. I know this trial's been going on a long time in Atlanta, and everybody's been like kind of tuned into it, just to see what the outcome will be. I try to go live, but hey, this is just a quick hey, down and dirty. This is what happened. The homie's out, and hopefully he's gonna get back to making music, doing good community, and doing good by himself. Especially if he has kids or what type of family he has, but he does good about. Body up, you know what I'm saying? And he go from there. So, hey, if you guys like this, please comment, subscribe to the channel. I thank you for rocking with your boy. And I just jumped in here. It's just something I don't normally do, but I just feel like, you know, this channel, we're going a different route. So we're going to stay current. I'm going to jump in on it. And as I learn how to go live with the equipment I got here, I'm going to do so. But if you guys here for the first time, please like the video. Subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you funky fresh people next time. Peace.